be certain to subscribe to this channel, Deprogram Enlightener, and also my backup channel, The True Disciples of Christ, and also A Spokesman for Men. Subscribe to this ministry as we're in the last days. This is the voice of Kahan Tazadok, Deprogram Enlightener. Be certain to subscribe to Tazadok on Instagram and Facebook as well. Shalom. Most High in Christ bless.
Shalom, brothers and sisters. Once again, it's the voice of Brother Tazadok. Today's date, according to their calendar, is January 29, 2012. For the record, I'd like to reserve all of my rights. This is not legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent attorney and please be advised. This is for entertainment, educational, and informational purposes only. Now, should you decide to use this information, you stumble, you fall on your face, it's your own fault because you did not research what was stated. Do not take anything that I say or anyone else for face value. It is your responsibility to research everything that you hear or read. I want to talk to you about common law because many of you do not have a clear comprehension of exactly what common law is. I would like to ask you, do many of you realize that law in the beginning, people that attended law school actually had to know the Bible. They had to study scriptures. This is the basis of all law. This is Bible. This is Bible. This is where many of us like to get you to swear upon it. You ever thought, like, why don't they have me swear on the Quran? Why don't they have me swear on the Guilt of Nothing? Why don't they have me to swear on whatever book? They want you to swear on the Bible. But then they tell you that it's the poison book or it's been tampered with. Because many of you, it is not given to understand this book known as the Bible. The understanding is only given to a selected few. But I don't want to go into that. I want to talk about common law. What is it? That's rhetorical. Common law is the beginning of all law. And Muslims say Allah. But Allah is not God in this world. All law, common law, is the beginning of all law. Therefore, one must actually clearly define and understand what common law is. Common law is the beginning of all law. And in its perfection, it's actually the absence of all law. That may have actually confuse many of you with that statement alone. But in today's society, it is known as public policy. Public policy. They call it law. It's public policy. Now, common law, summed up in simplistic terms, is actually what? The will of we, the people. The will of we, the people, and will actually manifest itself into actually separate cases as people. So rule with their mental state of conscious awareness and a sense of actually being fair, or fair place, you would say. So common law is a law that is common to what? To all people. Common law is common in the sense and is the law of Yahweh. Common law is the law of Yah. He gave us basic law by stating, do unto others as you would have them to do unto you. Now that's very simplistic. The creator of the UNI verse said, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. So common law actually supersedes all law and is superior in all cases to statutory law, or these rules and regulations and codes and so on and so forth. Common law actually establishes constitutions. Constitutions don't give you rights, brothers and sisters. That's paper. The Creator already gave you rights, and He gave you laws, statutes, and commandments from the Heavenly Father. And if you don't keep those laws, statutes, and commandments, and you abide by other laws, statutes, and commandments, then you're going wrong. He's omnipotent. And His laws are omnipotent to all law. So common law establishes constitutions as powers. Is actually inherited in the people. The common law actually established through the Constitution all restrictions of government. Now, government was instituted and created by man. Man was created by the Most High in His own image and likeness. The atheist, you could just go to hell because you're already in hell, and I'm not dealing with you right now. Evolutionists, I'm not dealing with you right now. I'm talking to those that are able to walk in the spiritual realm. If you're walking carnally, this is not for you anyways, because at some point, we're going to clash, because righteousness and wickedness cannot dwell together, and there's only two forces in this world. You're either operating on the side of righteousness, which is Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah, or you're operating on the side of wickedness, which is Satan. And many of you possess that spiritual realm. You're talking about evolution and so on and so forth. Man, this is all spiritual. This is a spiritual war. And I don't deal with religion, so don't try and place that on me. Oh, he come with that religion. No, I don't believe in religion. Religion is designed to control people, deriving from religo, meaning to hold down, to restrain, to bind. So religion was designed to hold down, restrain, and just bind your thinking, to hold you to a certain belief. I don't have a belief system. We deal with actual facts. But nevertheless, common law establishes constitutions as all powers is actually inherent in people. The common law establishes through the constitutions all the restrictions on government. So the government should be restricted by we, the people. So what in the hell has happened that you are now fearing government? And the government dictates what the people do when it should be in reverse. I'm not advocating any kind of violence, but this is truth. Government was given its power and instituted by we, the people. What happened? The constitutions never gave the government power for legislating people. We didn't do that. The Constitution didn't do that. Who created the Constitution? People did. The Constitution never gave the government power for legislating people. The government only has the power to legislate the workings of different functions of the various departments that allow people life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? So the Constitution can never establish common law, for then all the power would actually be not in we, the people, but would be in the Constitution. And the Constitution is only a piece of paper. And the people's right to address grievance or to amend or change or address any problem wouldn't be there. So, I mean, when you let Congress pass certain bills and you don't actually rebuke that nonsense, you're becoming deeper into this deception and mental manipulation and enslavement. You're becoming more and more chattel. The Heavenly Father created man and woman in his own image and likeness. Now, man, with help, created government. Make no mistake about it. And the government started what is known as corporations. So the Creator rules over man, and man rules over government. And government rules over corporations. So what happened, brothers and sisters? Why is the government ruling over you? Why do you fear the government? How many of you get a real safe feeling when you're driving on the interstate I-95 and a policeman, a state trooper, pulls up behind you? How many of you feel scared and safe? More than likely, the average response, and I don't do this, I'm going over it. When a person sees a policeman, the first thing they do is hit their brakes. And they become real fidgety and nervous. Because you know, in real truth, their primary function, supposedly being to protect and to serve, because why? You're public servants. And only you in law enforcement, under the sound of my voice, to hear me right now, you are public servants. Now you can like it, understand it, believe it or not, but that is your position. You're public servants. To serve and to protect, not to dictate, manipulate, and control. These public officials need to actually recognize their positions and recognize where their source of power really comes from. Now, this thing has been turned upside down, and the people are actually fearing government and those in public office, when you're supposed to fear no one but your Creator. So the Creator rules over man, man rules over government, and government rules over corporations. Government is what? Merely pieces of paper to actually be altered and changed to the whim of the living souls. Corporations are mere pieces of paper, that the government can actually change and alter at their whim. So the Creator is superior over man. Government and corporations, all of it, the Heavenly Father is above all of it. Man is superior to government and corporations. So why don't you stand up and act like men? And, what am I supposed to do? Why don't you stand up and be men? Why don't you research, and then you can stand strong like a man and face the atrocities that these people are actually plaguing the masses of the people with. You're supposed to be man. You're supposed to reflect God. Peace, God. You know what I'm talking about. You say, what are you talking about, Tata? I'm God. Psalms 82, verse 6. Did I not say that you are God and you are all children of the Most High? So I may not be the omnipotent, but when you think like God and you act like God, when you begin to think like a God and you act like a God, you become godly and you reflect God and you start to do righteous things. So you walk in that spirit. This is what Yeshua meant when he said, me and my Father, we are one. He didn't mean that they was the same entity. He mean that I'm so in tune with my Father. That which he say I do. That's what that which he command me, I do. So he was walking in the spirit of his Father so much that he became one with his Father. So, what are you going to be? You going to be the man, or are you still going to be chattel and bend over and scratch where you don't itch. Because this thing is really getting out of control. So educate yourself. Study scriptures. And many of you, you're making a grave error by throwing the Bible to the side. Many of you have Bibles, but it's up on the shelf because you say you respect knowledge. So you keep it up high and it's very dusty because you never take it out and you never read it. So the Creator is actually superior to man, the sovereign, so overranged. Government and corporations are under man. Man is superior to government and corporations. If man say that they do not exist, then damn it, they don't exist. Simply said, common law, public policy, is the will of the people. A law common to all people. Once again, my name is Tyler Dobb. Shalom.